Welcome back, friends. Hope everyone is taking good care of themselves, right? So let us go into our current affairs revision part 5. Okay, today we will be dealing with the different kinds of awards and indexes, sensors, right? So let us go ahead and see the topics for the day. So we will be seeing about the Asia Environment Enforcement Award, state of India's environment, or normalize the difference vegetation index. Okay, it's a type of index to evaluate the vegetation. And release of the Tiger Census Report 2018, report on illegal global trade in tigers by traffic, global assessment of forest biodiversity by WWF, World Bank report on water pollution, and there is recently a launch of index called SARAL by the Indian government. What is it? We'll see about that. And finally, we will look at the National Water Mission, Water Mission and its awards. And finally, we will look at the recent IPCC reports, right? Let us go ahead and see one by one. So, पहले टॉपिक ये है एशियाज एनवायरमेंट एनफोर्समेंट अवार्ड. सो ये दिस इज गिवन बाई यूएनईपी. ओके, सो इसको रिसेंटली रमेश पांडे, हु इज एन आईएफएस ऑफिसर, उनको दिया गया था. सो दिस इज इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट फॉर हिज रिकॉग्निशन फॉर कंबैटिंग ट्रांस बाउंड्री एनवायरमेंटल क्राइम. सो ही इज ऑल्सो वेरी मच इंस्ट्रूमेंटल इंट्रोड्यूसिंग द एम स्ट्रिप्स. सी, दिस हैज बीन आस्क्ड इन यूपीएससी प्रीलिम्स रिसेंटली. And this novel software has been used for patrolling in Dudhwa Tiger Reserve. Okay, so additional information here. यहाँ पे National Tiger Conservation Authority है. इसको origin है Wildlife Protection Act में 1972, and इसका head कौन है? PM है. ठीक है, this is very much important, please remember. So if a authority or some organization has its origin in an act, it is called a statutory organization. So please look at such kind of authorities, unka head kone, right? The second one is about the state of environment 2020. So this is given by the CSC. This also gives one magazine called as Down to Earth. This is one of the important sources for the environment and ecology. So ye kya batata hai? In recent few years there are 19 major extreme weather events like floods, droughts, right? So another important input from this report is more than 50 lakh internal displacement, who have internal migration in India, which is the highest in the world. Okay, so why? Because of the floods, cyclones, that is the Fani, Vayu, Bulbul, and droughts are also a significant reason for this. Next, we'll be looking at the normalized difference vegetation index. So what does it do? It states about the amount of the ground that is covered by vegetation. Its significance kya hai? Depending on the amount of vegetation, we will estimate the food abundance for the herbivorous animals. Usme forest area mein how much we can estimate the amount of the food abundance, and depending on that we can say it is whether that particular habitat is healthy for the particular species or not. Okay, so kaise calculate karte hain? They evaluate the difference between the red and the near infrared components of the light using satellite. Okay, so depending on that amount of the absorption by the and reflection of the same, we will evaluate the presence of the vegetation in that particular area. Okay, so however ye recently news mein kya kyun aaya hai, because now they are saying that this is not a reliable estimate for the finding the food abundance. Okay, so the next topic is about regarding the tiger census, which is very much important. Though this has came in 2018, earlier 2014 mein aaya tha. So according to this report, presently India has 2967 tigers. Okay, and with respect to 2006, there is 100% increase. Okay, more than 100% increase. 2006 mein there were no, like, complete wiped out ho gaye the tigers. Kahan pe? Sariska in Rajasthan. Okay, and according to this report, Gir forest mein highest rise hua tha, which is 27%. With respect to states, MP is in first position, followed by Karnataka and Uttarakhand. Okay, this report also says no tigers were recorded in Buxa, which is in West Bengal, Dampa, which is in Mizoram. See, aspirants, Mizoram is also known for the highest amount of the forest cover. Okay, land mein in state wise mein first position hai iska. Next, Palamu, that is a Jharkhand. Okay, technologies used for this tiger census, kya use karte hain? M-strips, as we see in the first slide, cataract. Okay, so and we have one project called tiger, for a project tiger, which is for the conservation of the tigers, right? So this has its origin in Wildlife Protection Act 1972. There are another initiative by WWF that is called as TX2. Here, remember, 2 matlab doubling the wildlife tigers population ka. And there is one standard that is given by WWF. What does it say? It evaluates how the tiger habitat management is done by the particular nations or the governments, right? So remember, simply cats. So the next topic is about the traffic, which has given a report on the illegal trade on the tigers, right? So remember, traffic is an NGO. Nature of the organization is very much important. Traffic is an NGO, along with the partnership with the WWF, that the World Wildlife Fund and IUCN has given this report. So it has estimated that more than 2,000 tigers have been illegally trade of different parts. Okay, so the highest kahan pe tha? India or China mein tha, followed by the Indonesia. The next one is about the assessment, global assessment given by the WWF of the forest biodiversity. So this is given by, as we said, WWF. Okay, so it is the first ever global assessment. Remember, this is the first ever global assessment. So this is based on forest specialist index. It's a kind of index. Based on this index, they have come up with this first ever global assessment. Okay, so this is followed by the Living Planet Index methodology. A methodology pe they have developed this one. Depending on this, they have come up with this assessment. Okay, according to this, they found out that 53% decline in the number of forest wildlife populations. Okay, this is very much important. So recently, World Bank has come up with a report on the water pollution. Okay, so the biggest ever database assembled on the water pollution by the World Bank. So according to this, what does it say? Clean water is the key for the economic development or the economic growth. See, even this point can be used as a point in sustainable development or in any context in the means also. Okay, remember this point. So ye kya batata hai key contributor kya hai? Nitrogen hai. We have also seen this in our part 3 class, where we found that nitrogen pollution already threshold limit pe aa gaya. We have also seen that the Columbia Declaration deals with such nitrogen pollution, and we have seen one initiative called as Nitrogen for Life. Okay, please recapitulate it. So ye kya hota hai? Because of this creates hypoxia and dead zones, matlab lack of oxygen, that is creating the dead zones. Okay, so what happening is, because of this extra nitrates which if exposed to children, that is affecting their growth and brain development. Okay, this is very much important. So recently there is one index in the news that is called as SARAL. Iska matlab kya hai? State Rooftop Solar Attractiveness Index. So how it is developed? It is developed jointly by the ministry that on the new and renewable energy, and SSEF, that stands for Shakti Sustainable Energy Foundation. It's a kind of foundation, and ASCOM, right? So this is regarding the Association of the Chambers and Industry. Okay, so these together have jointly developed this attractiveness index. Okay, so what is its purpose? So it evaluates the attractiveness by the Indian states. How this promotes a type of the competitive federalism. Kaisa? Like how states are promoting the initiatives in the context of solar power infrastructure. Okay, so this is a first of kind index. So as I said, it creates a healthy competition, that is a competitive federalism. So how they find out? They take up the 5 key aspects, that is the robustness of the policy making, implementing the environment, investment in the climate projects, and consumer experience and business ecosystem. So depending on these 5 aspects, they have ranked in different Indian states. Yahan they found out that Karnataka has topped this, and this is released by the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. So next we will look at the National Water Mission Awards. So kisliye they are why they give this? For the excellence, for recognizing the excellence in water conservation, how efficiently they are using the water, and the sustainable water management practices. Okay, this is given as a part of National Water Mission, which is one of the 8 missions of NAPCC, that is National Action Plan for Climate Change. Okay, remember there are 8 such missions. What are the such missions? National Solar Mission, solar energy ke baare mein, and enhance energy efficiency, that is like the how the energy efficiency has been increasing. Later on, the Sustainable Habitat, National Water Mission, as we discussed this, National Mission for the sustaining the Himalayan ecosystem, okay, and National Mission on the Green India, that is on the developing the forest areas, okay, afforestation initiatives, National Mission on Sustainable Agriculture, National Mission for Strategic Knowledge for the Climate Change. Okay, so we'll see the next topic is about the IPCC reports. ये क्या बताता है रिसेंटली दिस अ डायरेक्ट थ्रेट फॉर द ओशन. सो रिसेंटली व्हाट हैपेंड, आई आल्सो एडेड वन मोर करंट अफेयर्स हियर. सो दिस हैज बीन वी डिस्कस्ड इन आल्सो पार्ट 2 ऑफ द आवर क्लास. सो दे हैव रिलीज्ड टू इंपॉर्टेंट रिपोर्ट्स, स्पेशल रिपोर्ट ऑन द क्लाइमेट चेंज एंड द लैंड. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट टाइम दे हैव रिलीज्ड ऑन द लैंड. ओके, सो व्हाट डज इट से, ग्लोबल फूड सिस्टम्स हैज बीन कंट्रीब्यूटिंग 1/3 of all the greenhouse gases. Okay, and the next report is about on the ocean and cryosphere in changing the in a changing climate. Okay, what is say, the complete increasing temperatures, further ocean acidification, marine heat waves has been occurring, and the more frequency extreme El Nino and La Nina events are also occurring. Okay, so we have also seen what is the foundation, some basic points about IPCC in part C. Please do see, like it has been come up by the initiate of WMO and UNEP. Okay, and we have also seen how the recent IPCC third world group meet is occurring in India. Okay, so please refer to that. Okay, so please do share your feedback. Please let me know if I can improve somewhere some points. Okay, and please act smartly while judging on look like amount of the time spending on the current affairs. Okay, and also please refer to the past MCQs. And one tip I would like to give, please see the type of MCQs that is been given by the UPCC UPSC in the recent exams, might be CDS. Okay, please go through that also. Okay, take care, we'll see in the next class.